Hello, hi friends. In this video, we are going to see how generative AI or Gen AI can help us with different kinds of use cases. Generative AI or Gen AI has been a hype for quite some time now since ChatGPT announced its arrival. People have been trying to retrofit many of the use cases using generative AI and solutions which can be implemented, business solutions which can benefit from these kind of technologies. Gen AI or generative AI has use cases in many industries and many areas or many verticals. Most common use case is to generate content, not just textual content, but we can use Gen AI for generating video content. We can use it for creating images. We can use it for identifying patterns in things like healthcare, for example. We can use it for scanning the images and look at the images to diagnose potential problems with the patient's history and things like that. In this video, we are going to see how we can use generative AI in a different context where it can be used to summarize the video content. My name is Nilesh and let's get started. I've been creating content for quite a long time using YouTube, and I also consume a lot of YouTube content or video content. Sometimes it happens that we don't have enough time to go through the whole of video and we want to get a quick summary of what the content creator is trying to do. I came across a couple of tools which uses AI to generate a summary of the video content. I'm going to demonstrate that and share my experience of using those tools. Let's start by copying the link to my video which is required for both of these tools. First one is called as the NodeGPT. So this one is using AI to summarize YouTube video content, and we are supposed to paste the link to our YouTube video here, and then we can say generate summary. While the summary is getting generated, I'm also going to go on to another tool which is called as the quickrecap.ai. This is also similar, where we have to provide the link to the YouTube video and it also generates a summary for us. Both these tools are going to analyze my videos and then it's going to provide me a summary of that content. If you look at the size of this video, which is named as easiest way to enable KEDA on Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS cluster, it is around 15 minutes in length. And this particular tool, the Quick Recap, it's able to generate the summary quite quickly. We can then hit the view summary button and it will generate the summary for us. Same way, the NodeGPT, it shows us the summary in line without having to go into the quick summary of that particular, or without having to click any other button on the UI of NodeGPT. Now let's quickly analyze what is the result of this summary. We can see that in the NodeGPT, it gives the summary in a bullet point ways, like where it says enable KEDA, which is the Kubernetes based event driven auto scaling on Azure Kubernetes Service cluster. Then it talks about KEDA is a lightweight component that allows scaling based on events. It says that it's providing a script to create a AKS cluster and provides out of box scalers which come from KEDA, and the different scalers based on Apache Kafka, CPU, Datadog, etc. And it talks about verifying. And then it shows a highlight where enable KEDA on Azure Kubernetes cluster, user provided a script, scales based on external events, and verification of the KEDA using kubectl get pods, then access previous videos. So basically it is doing a quick summary of what I discussed during the length of this video, and I think it does a decent job in terms of what I have demonstrated in this video. Now let's look at the other option, the quick recap, and this is where we have to click that option or the button to say view summary, but the summary is shown below the video or link to the video, and it is much more detailed in terms of what it shows, and it gives the summary as a third person. So you can see that here it says, in this video, the speaker introduces KEDA and explains how to to enable it on Kubernetes cluster. They mentioned that they've been using KEDA for their public talks and have experience with AKS, the managed offering from Microsoft Azure for Kubernetes. Then they talk about KEDA being a lightweight component, which is used which can be added to any Kubernetes cluster, and the concept of horizontal pod autoscaler, which is used to trigger the scaling based on events outside the cluster. Then it says how we can get started with KEDA using the KEDA.sh website, and what are the out-of-box scalers. It also highlights the things that I mentioned during the video, like Apache Kafka, Couchbase, Cassandra, CPU, and more. And then it says the speaker explains that the easiest way it found to enable the KEDA on AKS is during the cluster creation itself. So somehow I have a feeling that this particular quick recap AI tool is doing much better job at summarizing the actual content or the actual video as compared to the NodeGPT, because it talks about various things that I have mentioned in terms of how the script is using the subscription name, the resource group, location, things around the Azure Kubernetes version, the Azure Container Registry. These things are missing in the NodeGPT. And then it also talks about how I explain the concept of running a PowerShell script using the script named initialize AKS. That is the first part where you can think of this video as logically being divided into two parts. In the first half, or in the first part of the video, it's creating the Azure Kubernetes service cluster with KEDA enabled on that. And the second part is more around the verification. And this is where you can see the second part is also very well captured and summarized for me. So if I am the consumer of this information, if I'm looking at this summary, I can very well know which parts I have to refer to if I'm running short of time, or let's say I already know how to create a Kubernetes cluster, but then I need to know how to verify whether KEDA is installed on that particular cluster or not. I can straight away go to this section starting at 6 minutes 35 seconds and till the end of the video, where we talk about how to verify using the kubectl get pods or the kubectl command line. Also use other commands like the getcrd to verify the custom resource definitions. And in this video, I'm also talking about what are the KEDA versions which are supported for a specific version of Kubernetes. So that part is also very well summarized here. So based on my experience of using these two tools, which do the quick summary of YouTube video, I would say that quickrecap.ai does a fantastic job in terms of summarizing a 15-minute video into two paragraphs as compared to NodeGPT. Both are doing a decent job or good amount of job, but in terms of the way it is presented to me as an end user, I personally feel that quickrecap.ai does a fantastic job. I'm pretty sure there are other tools in the market which are doing something similar, and there might be more than one utilities or more than one projects which are using the ChatGPT or which are using generative AI to summarize the video content. If you have come across any such tool, please feel free to comment them and recommend them. I would love to know about these kind of tools. I hope you found this video useful and you will like the content. Please go ahead, like the video, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your friends and family. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.